Job, Job, chapter 9. And Job answered and said, "Truly I know it is so. But how is man right with Elohim? If one wished to dispute with him, he would not answer him one time out of a thousand. Wise in heart and potent of power, who has hardened himself against him and is at peace? He who removes mountains, and they do not know it, when he overturns them in his displeasure, who shakes the earth out of its place, and its columns tremble, who commands the sun, and it does not rise, and he seals up the stars, stretching out the heavens by himself, and treading upon the waves of the sea, who made Ash, Kisil, and Kemah, and the rooms of the south, who performs great and unsearchable deeds, and innumerable wonders. Look, he goes by me, and I do not see, and he moves past, but I do not discern him. Look, he snatches away. Who brings it back? Who says to him, 'What are you doing?' Eloah does not turn back his displeasure. The helpers of pride stoop under him. How much less would I answer him, choose my words with him? For though I were righteous, I would not answer him. I prayed to him for my right ruling. Though I had called and he answered me, I would not believe that he was listening to my voice. For he crushes me with a storm and has multiplied my wounds for no cause. He does not allow me to recover my breath, but fills me with bitterness. If I speak of power, look, he is potent. And if of right ruling, who sets me a time? If I am righteous, my mouth would declare me wrong. Am I perfect? It would declare me perverse. Am I perfect? Do I not know my own being? I despise my life. It is all the same, therefore I say, he destroys the perfect and the wrong. If the scourge slays suddenly, he laughs at the trial of the innocent. Earth has been given into the hand of the wrong. He covers the faces of its judges. If it is not he, then who is it? My days have become swifter than a runner. They have fled. They have not seen good. They have passed by like swift ships, like an eagle swooping on its prey. If I say, 'Let me forget my complaint, let me put off my sad face, and let me smile,' I shall be afraid of all my sufferings. I know that you do not hold me innocent. If I am wrong, why should I labor in vain? If I wash myself with snow water and cleanse my hands with soap, then you would plunge me into a ditch and my garments shall abhor me. For he is not a man as I am, that I answer him, and we come together into right ruling. There is no mediator between us to lay his hand upon us both. Let him take his rod away from me, and let not his dread frighten me. Then I would speak and not fear him, for I am not so within myself."